This area is kind of big on throwing the birds at you temporarily. Such as right now, the birds will fly around at you until you get to this area, then they'll just disappear. This happens a little bit later in the level, actually. I have to get through here, but the door is locked, so... easy fix. Oh, shit! Hey, explosive barrel. I can think of a few easy ways to solve this situation. Well, mainly one. But it worked. And that's all that matters. Fortunately, because of that light, we don't have to worry about anything coming behind us. Which is always nice, knowing that you aren't gonna get enemy spawns from behind. This place seems pretty stocked up, and this is also leading to my second favorite part of the game. You remember the scene on the stage of the old gods of Asgard? This is similar.
And here's a new song from a band that they always remind me of our local rock legends, the old gods. I couldn't tell you why. I guess it's just, you know, one of those things. Anyway, here's Poets of the Fall and their latest single, War.
They actually did just drop the actual name of the band. And the reason why it reminds them of it is because the old gods and Poets of the Fall are the same. It's actually kind of quiet right now, so I'm going to turn it up, and I will let you guys enjoy this. And that's about it for this part. I mean the standoff stage, not the part of the let's play. Anyway, although this is going to be a short part. Anyway, not quite as good as the rock stage part, but hey, I really like it. It's great music. That is War by Poets of the Fall. Interesting thing about that song is that they actually did a music video for it for Alan Wake.
The power plant glowed in the night. It was close, but I had to find a way across.
In which they used the live-action model that Alan Wake was based off of. So, interesting bit of trivia there. Not really sure if it qualifies as trivia, though I don't know too many people who know about it. That's going to be the level gimmick for this bit is the power lines. We saw them in an earlier episode when we were going through, I believe it was the farm, where there were some broken power cables. But since it does fit, since we are at the I think it's the power plant. So this level is big on throwing a lot of enemies at you, especially difficult enemies to kill. But fortunately, they give you a lot of tricks to get instant kills on them, such as this. Interesting thing about that light source is that it always acts as a checkpoint. Okay, just gotta get through this door here. Alright. Maybe I can jump over it. Nope. It's wedged in there pretty good. Come on. Get down. Get off. There we go. Well, something you can do with these enemies is you can try to force them back into the power cables with the flashlight, since they do tend to step back. Or you can try to shoot them into it, since they take a few steps back when they get shot. But that can be difficult at times. So another situation that I've found works out very well is that you can just run around the power boxes.
Making her way through the water pipe alone, Cynthia was angry at the rider. Foolish young man, taking unnecessary risks. And the way he broke the rules. Didn't he understand what was at stake? Since the terrible days in the 70s, she hadn't wavered once, as hard as it had been. She was tired of protecting the town all these long years, and now only wanted to rest.
Seems like the lamp lady has been doing this for a long time. And you know, I know that her character really is an homage to the log lady from Twin Peaks. However, rather than the log lady, she actually seems to have a reason for the thing that she carries around. I love doing that. You can force them to walk back into the power lines with a flare. And unfortunately, due to some, a little bit of lag or something, I wound up using two flares instead of just one. But we got some coffee to take the edge off anyway. So it's all good. Yes, the lamp lady actually does have a reason for carrying around the lamp. It's that she's pretty terrified of the darkness, as, you know, I can understand that. Whereas the log lady, well, she carried around her log from being terrified of industrialism, I don't know.
The story I had written in the cabin had come true. Touched by the dark presence, I had written a horror story, but the end was still missing. The story was incomplete, and the last unfinished page of the manuscript still sat in the typewriter in the cabin study. If I could get back there, if I could read the page, then I could write my own ending to this story and save Alice.
You really didn't do yourself any favors when you wrote that page, did you, Wake? Hey, look, some birds. What? Apparently magic vanishing birds, but okay. Who just leaves a coffee thermos there? I have to admit, that part actually did make me kind of jump. I wasn't expecting him to just burst out of the door like that. Flare gun? We haven't had one of these in a long time. What are you planning, game? Okay, just gotta wait for the bridge to rotate over. Just waiting for it. Any day now. Almost. There we go. I kinda have to wonder why they have a rotary bridge here. I mean, it doesn't really lead to anything when it's turned the other way. Aw, oh, missed it. Well, we'll get on the other pass. And since we've got so many swarms of birds, you can kind of assume that this is what the flare gun is for. But remember how the birds disappeared when we got to the hut before? You do something similar here, so we can just save the flare gun ammo. Because they disappear once you get into this doorway. Which houses a shotgun, coffee, and more importantly, a Night Springs episode.
Are we men dreaming of being butterflies, or butterflies that dream of being men? Such philosophical concerns are, by necessity, abstract. And yet, some of us can find concrete proof of the nature of our existence in Night Springs. Tonight's episode, An Absence of Creativity.
Martha, what did you want to show me?
Oh, Lydia, thank God you're here. Please, it's in the basement.
Oh, Martha. Oh, that's amazing.
Isn't it just? I found it here this morning.
It's like it isn't there. Straight at it.
Yes, I'm sorry about that.
How did you get here?
Well, I'm trying to work.
Did you put this thing here?
In a way. To be more precise, I put everything here but that.
Really? But what is it?
Oh, I guess the temptation is to call it a hole, but it's really an absence, a profound lack of reality.
In Martha's basement?
Yes. I was doing so well, too. I came up with two old ladies and put something really weird in the basement. It was a great start. But I'm completely blocked now. I can't imagine what I was up to.
Well, surely it's just an ordinary basement.
Is it? Why did you call your friend here, then?
Well, I don't know.
Oh, well.
Couldn't you just ignore it?
Oh, no, I couldn't do that. It would probably turn into a plot hole. Might be one already. Could sink the whole enterprise.
Oh, my.
Listen, ladies, not to be rude, but I'm really not at all sure where I'm going with this, and you're just not helping. You should just go back upstairs for a cup of coffee while I try to figure out what I'm up to.
Well, if you think that's best.
Maybe I should just stop here. Or is that too moronic?
Is that too moronic? Indeed. Who can tell? It's a fine line between the stupid and the sublime. In Night Springs.
Sorry if that bridge turning distracted you at all. But is it just me, or hey, helicopter?
We managed to lose the flock! You're almost at the power plant! Keep going! We'll give you support!
So their light will act as a secondary flashlight. Anyway, is it just me, or Did one of those old ladies, the second one that was visiting her friend, sound exactly like Lucy from Twin Peaks? Maybe that was intentional, or maybe I'm just looking for references here. The game does have a lot, so you can't help it sometimes. As for the strength of the helicopter light, it's about the strength of one of the power company lights. So it takes down their shield very, very quickly. I like this portion of the game because it starts getting more creative. Not that it was uncreative before, but they start mixing things up well. It's not taking the same formula that you know from the very first half of the game and applying it to the rest. It actually mixes things up. And even though we're getting attacked by birds, might as well take a look at this stash, because it's got to be close by. And if we're getting attacked by birds while getting it, then it's gotta be good. Yes, it is quite good. And then we can hear the breathing again, which kind of suggests that these are given to us by Thomas Zane, almost like Alan Wake wrote him in to help us by giving us these stashes. Or it could have been the lamp lady who put these out, but then why do we hear Thomas Zane? I was gonna check behind. Anyway, we got a spare flashbang, why not?
I recognized the logo on the power plant sign. I'd seen a version of it painted all over the area, signifying hidden caches of supplies.
Safe haven. Wow, finally something new written in yellow.
Right there!
Miss Weaver! Cynthia! I'm a friend!
Prove it!
You knew Zane! Thomas Zane! You're the Lady of the Light in the song! You can help me!
About time! Young man, I've been waiting a very long time for you.
So the power company really lets this lady live in here? Well, I guess she does keep the lights on.
It's in the well-lit room.
Excuse me?
What you need to drive the darkness back. The well-lit room is at the dam. I built the room to keep it safe.
Will it help me find Alice? Will it get me back to the cabin? Fine, let's go. I can get my friends to come back with the helicopter.
Oh, we won't go outside. Never at night. That's rule number one. You've been breaking the rules, young man, and where has that gotten us, Secret route, a blip route, an old water pipe. Something was damaged at the transformer yard. It's draining all the reserve power. Without it, the pipe will go dark. The power to the yard must be cut.
Let me guess. You want me to do it?
Young man, you're the one who likes to break the rules. I can't be outside in the dark. The kill switch is outside.
Wait a minute. If she was the one writing all this stuff, then that means she was also the one who wrote all that stuff on the walls in that really, really creepy basement. I don't know about being alone with her. See if we can actually use these. No, Now, despite them being such an obvious advantage, it can actually be pretty difficult to get them to walk into it. So generally, you're better off kind of just walking around it in circles to drain their shield. That's usually the better strategy. Trying to push them back with a flare or your flashlight.
Weaver had sent me to cut the power to the transformer yard. I was willing to do grunt work for her to get her to help me. I hoped Weaver was dependable. I'd stumbled into this crazy world a little over a week ago. She had been living this insanity for decades.
Yeah, okay, we get it. Rule number one, don't go outside.
I could see the kill switch that would cut the power to the transformer yard. Now I had to find a way to reach it.
Hey, this looks like a puzzle. Well, I guess we're authorized by Cynthia. Lamp lady. Oh, let's take a look here to see exactly what we need to do. So it looks like we need to press all the buttons to extend the walkways across every platform. It's kind of a stupid system for a power company to have, but hey, let's roll with it, I guess. Now you could remember what the combination is, or you could be a man and solve it like everybody else solves puzzles in video games with buttons. Press everything until it works. Hey, I got it! Oh, wait. Okay, this might be a while. Haha! Keep the lights on. Okay. Did you really need to write all these things down?
Who designs these things?
Probably electricians. I honestly do not know what he was talking about when he said who designs
the
these things.
The yard went dark and dead. Weaver's water pipe passage should now be good to go.
So it seems like the darkness really doesn't care that the power company or the power plant is right there. It's taken over right outside the doors, so I guess I can see why she carries that lamp around with her.
Take care of your tools.
Chainsaw, some enemies. Luckily, we got a lot of flashbangs and a lot of flares. Oh shit, he's not. There we go. You know, the chainsaw enemies really just look a lot more intimidating than they actually are. Seeing as how we've just got this button here, theoretically you could just drop a flare on the ground and run straight to the door.
This way, young man. Follow me. Come, come. The pipe's empty now. We're ready to go. This way. We need to go. I knew them both, Tom and Barbara. I had such a crush on him. Such a beautiful man. I was jealous. There was a part of me that was maybe a little glad when she had the accident. And then Tom started writing and woke the darkness up. He tried to bring her back, but you can't do that. There are no free rides like that.
I'm starting to realize that.
In that case, young man, perhaps you're a smarter man than Tom was. The witch looked like her, but it wasn't. Barbara was sweet. He didn't understand until it was too late. He tried to undo it, wrote himself, her, everything he'd ever written out of the world. Oh, he was so famous. And afterward, no one knew. Oh, Tom. He left only one thing behind in my care, in case it happened again. Insurance. He trusted me. Or perhaps used me a little. Tom knew how I felt. Knew I wouldn't refuse him. I built the well-lit room and put it there. It's been waiting for you. We are characters trapped in a story you have written, and none of us will survive to see the end of it. If the darkness isn't stopped, she'll twist the story to her own dark ends.
How do you know all this?
Tom, that's the way he wrote it. He still talks to me, you know, in television, from beyond, from below. We have both been touched by the darkness, young man. He saved us both with light, but the darkness stays with you. Use a stain. This pipe will take us directly to the well-lit room.
Okay, I need to call my friends, tell them where we're going.
Hello? Ow!
Barry, we're headed to the dam in one of the pipes. Meet us there.
Okay, I'll tell Sarah.
It's Sarah now? We gotta go see if they're okay.
They're probably dead. You must reach the well-lit room. This is no time to be a selfish idiot.
That's my best friend!
Well, be a fool. I'll use the pipe. I'll meet you at the dam if you make it.
At least I didn't have to worry about her. She knew how to stay safe.
That was the fruitiest jump ever, Wake. Anyway, I'll see you in the next part.
Somebody's